Hi everyone, my name is Emmanuel Obodo. I'm a specialist biomedical scientist and I'm also a lecturer in biomedical science here in the UK. I completed my PhD in biomedical science. I have extensive experience working in NHS as a specialist biomedical scientist. And for many years, I've helped a number of people secure their dream job as a specialist biomedical scientist and also as a biomedical scientist. I'm here to help you to navigate through interview questions and thereby increase your chances of getting a job as a biomedical scientist. I ask that you like, share, comment, and subscribe our page. Thank you. Hi everyone again. So today we are going to be looking at a few things that are common questions they ask. Number one, they ask about what is quality control. Another thing they can ask is, do you understand laboratory audit? Or they may just say audit, okay? Another thing they may ask you is, what do you do when your control sample failed? Another question they may also ask you will be, if you notice that one of your analyzers have been given a wrong result or abnormal result, what are you going to do? Now I'm going to answer these four questions for you and I'm going to make it very, very simple. Okay, once again, my name is Dr. Emmanuel Obodo. I've been working in the UK as a specialist biomedical scientist and also I'm a lecturer in biomedical science here in the United Kingdom. So what is quality? Quality talks about expectant. Quality talks about standard, reference point, that is quality. And what is control? Control talks about regulating, monitoring, okay? Now, what is assurance? Assurance talks about confidence. When you say someone has reassured you, it talks about confidence. So before I get into other terminology, so what is quality control? Try not to just say quality control is this or that. Remember, there are types of quality control and try to link it to quality assurance. First of all, I'm going to want you to know that each of these quality aspects, they are known as quality management system. So how will you define this? How will you answer this question? They ask you, what is quality control? Your answer is this. Thank you very much. Quality control is a form of quality management system that ensures that standard, precision, and accuracy is maintained within the laboratory. That there are two types of quality control, internal quality control and external quality control. That internal quality control talks about the verified method within the laboratory that ensure that standard and accuracy will be maintained within the laboratory. While external quality control talks about external regulatory bodies that ensure that quality has been maintained in the laboratories. For example, NHS. The NHS send sample on monthly basis. And when they send the samples, each of the laboratory will run the sample and submit their result. That from the result they submit, NHS will go through it and give a report indicating whether the laboratories has maintained quality or not. So that is external quality control. You can also then say that there is also another aspect of quality control, which is called quality assurance. That quality assurance talks about confidence that the standard has been maintained, or confidence that the standard will be maintained. Again, there are two types of quality assurance: internal quality assurance and external quality assurance. Internal quality assurance talks about the same principle or the same method, verified method, put in place that ensure or that gives confidence that the standard will be maintained. And external quality assurance is also external regulatory body, the process they put in place to also ensure that the standard will be maintained within the laboratory. Now, the next question they may likely to ask you is, what is audit? These audits, these things, they are kind of linked. So when you talk about audit, it kind of follow quality assurance. So what is audit? Audit is just a way of trying to make sure that the standard is being followed. For example, it looks at both the analyzer, it looks at both the personnel, the staffs. What are they doing? I'm going to give you an example before I define audit. Because there's a standard operating procedure within the laboratory, and everyone is expected to follow it. And when we follow it, we call it conformance. But when you don't follow that process, it's called non-conformance. Okay? So what audit ensures is that there is conformance, that everyone is following according to the standard. So laboratory audit talks about the process of quality management system that ensure that the standard operating procedure is being followed. Or you can say that it's a form of quality management system that ensures that quality has been followed or has been maintained. Again, there are two types of audit. You have internal audit, you have external audit. An internal audit is a process within the laboratory that ensures that the quality is being followed. For example, you will see things like a senior member of staff can come to you and ask you a question about the process. Maybe, for an example, can you tell me how do you validate your result? How do you validate full blood count result? Or if this happened, what would you do? So that member of staff that is asking you that question, remember, before you are allowed to validate a result, you have proven that you are competent and your competency has been signed, okay? So what that member of staff is trying to do is trying to make sure that the way you are working is according to the standard. Then you will explain, I validate results this way or that way. If this happened, I do this or that. When you are doing that, that is what we call internal audit. So that member of staff will now examine your answer and determine whether your answer has followed quality within the laboratory. That's internal audit. Now, external audit does the same thing, but what is different is that it's the external regulatory body that will do that. For example, UCAS. So UCAS will come to assess the laboratory and make sure that they are following standard, that they are following standard procedure to ensure that they maintain high standard of ISO laboratories. That is why when UCAS come to the laboratory to assess them, they don't just look, they look at your method, your quality, they look at your standard operating procedure, they look at the personnel, what are their qualifications, what are their training, is the competencies up to date, and so on and so forth. So these are form of audit. So in general, audit ensure that the quality has been followed, or audit ensure that quality is being followed. That is audit, whether it's internal or external. Another likely question they will ask you, that when they will ask you something like, they said, what would you do if your quality control sample fell? This is one of the common questions they ask. When you get such questions, what are you going to do? You tell them there are so many factors that can affect quality control samples. Number one, that it can be from the control samples. If it is not from the control sample, it could be from the environment, such as temperature. If it is not from the environment, it could be from maybe something like reagents, okay? If it is not from the reagent, then it could be from the analyzer. Just tell them these four things, then start taking it one after the other. You say, for an example, you are going to check your quality control samples. Is it underfilled or is it insufficient? That if it is insufficient, what you are going to do, you will discard that and get a new vial. That's a new quality control samples. But if you look at it, it is not underfilled. That the next thing you are going to look at, when was this quality control sample open? When is it in use? Has it been more than 7 days? If it is more than 7 days, that is possible that quality control sample has deteriorated. Therefore, you will get a new quality control samples. But if you check it, that was not the case, that you may then need to look at the environment and ask yourself, how long has that sample been kept at the room temperature? For an example, if it is a quality control sample that you need to put in the room temperature, sometimes recommendation might be maybe half an hour or 15 minutes. Some people might put it there 2 hours and they've forgotten. That can affect the quality control sample. Then you tell them they are going to check how long has that quality control sample be left in the room temperature. If it is outside the range as what it's supposed to do, what it then means that you might need to use another quality control sample. But if that is not the case, another thing you might need to look at is what's the temperature of that environment, of the laboratory environment. Because if the temperature is too warm, it can also affect the quality control samples. And if that is the case, if you think that the temperature is too high, you can regulate the temperature of that laboratory. And of course, you get a new vial as well. But if you have checked this whole thing, it's not the quality control sample, it is not the environment, that another thing may be reagent. So you now look at, has the reagent expired? So you look at, if the reagent has expired, of course you are going to remove that reagent, take the reagent off and put a new reagent, okay? But if the reagent has not expired, the next you might need to look at, is there enough reagent, you know, in the can? If there's not enough reagent, and of course you have to change the reagent to make sure there's enough reagent. Another thing that I forgot to also mention when it comes to quality control sample is this. You also check whether the quality control sample has it expired or has it not expired. So these are some things you are going to look at. If you have checked, it's not the quality control sample, it is not the environment like the temperature or how long that sample has been kept, and it is not the reagent, that the next target will be from the analyzer. Could it be from the analyzer? So then you now look at the analyzer, and if you think possibly it's going to be from the analyzer, what you then need to do is to do maintenance. So you do analyzer maintenance and you do calibration. After you've done the maintenance, done your calibration, then you can repeat the quality control. And of course, if it passed, then it suggests that it is the analyzer's problem. But if you have done all that and it's still failing, and what are you going to do? So if you have done all this whole thing and there's nothing else to do, what you do then is to put that analyzer out of use and log it in and call engineers to come and have a look at it. That is your answer of what you are going to do if your quality control sample failed. Another question to this could be, you notice that one of your analyzers started giving abnormal results. Sometimes they may say you have noticed that one of your analyzers have started giving maybe high white cell count or high neutrophils, as the case may be. Maybe they may say you've noticed that one of your analyzers has started giving abnormal results. What are you going to do? Very simple. Tell them what you are going to do, that as soon as you've noticed that it has happened, you are going to check all the samples that has gone through that analyzer from the time that it started happening, and you bring those samples out first. What you then do is that you isolate that very analyzer from other analyzers. Then what you're going to do is to do a maintenance on that analyzer. You can even do calibration on that analyzer and repeat the quality control. If the quality control pass, okay, what you would then do is to get samples that has gone through on another analyzers and put it there and compare the result it will give you on that particular analyzer with the other analyzer. If it gives you the same result, yes, you have solved the problem. However, maintenance, and you do the quality control and it's still failing, what you are going to do, then put that analyzer out of use and call engineer to come and have a look or look at it. Remember, when you also take that sample from the analyzers, the one that has gone through that particular analyzer, what you do is to run it with other analyzers and compare the result. If you notice there's a change, and of course you validate the one given to you from the other analyzer that is not giving you problem. So that is your answer when it comes to quality control, when it comes to audits, when it comes to what do you do when your quality control sample failed, and also when it comes to if you notice that one of your analyzer is giving abnormal result, what are you going to do? Let me tell you what I've done. What I've done was to give you keys that when you go for interview and they ask you question on quality control or on anything like audit, don't just define them. Give them detail. Give them example. The answer that I've given to you is to simplify them for you. So that is your answer today. Next time, I'm going to look at NHS report and other things. Thank you very much, and please continue to subscribe, like, share, and put your comment. Thank you so much till I come back your way again. Bye.